टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल कंटिन्यू हिज लेक्चर ऑन हिज बुक ऑफ द परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट एंड टुडे ही विल डिस्कस अबाउट द असेसमेंट सेंटर। प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार हैज रिटन न्यूमरस रिसर्च पेपर एंड बुक्स and his publications are published throughout the world. In the continuation of the performance management, he will discuss today about the assessment center. An assessment center is a comprehensive standardized procedure in which multiple assessment techniques such as a situational exercises and the job simulation, business games, discussion, reports, and presentation are used to evaluate individual employee for a variety of the decision. For any of the organization, evaluation of the individual employee is important. For the individual employee, you evaluate that the how and you take the decision that the what to do with the individual employee, either the promotion will be there and what type of the promotion and increment in the salary will be there. Hence this can be done with the help of the standardized procedure of the assessment center. Most frequently, though, the approach has been applied to the individuals being considered for the selection, promotion, placement, or a special training and development in the management. This approach is used for the selection of the employee, promotion of the employee, placement of the employee, and a special training and development in the management of the employee. Promotion of the employee. A decision to promote is essentially a decision to select from within the organization those most likely to succeed at the higher level jobs. Any method used by the organization to take promotion decision, such as performance appraisal data, interviews, etc., should be supplemented by the data from the assessment center. Since the assessment center method is used to study the likely performance and behavior of a person in a role not previously performed by him or her, it can be used to supplement promotion decision using the additional inputs, not only results in a more appropriate decision. It also helps eliminate individual biases and imparts more transparency and the fairness to the promotion system. High validity has been reported in use of the assessment center data for promotion to the first level supervisory and the middle management level, while the no validity study have been reported for the higher levels of the management. How to do the promotion in an organization? This can be done by this decision as a performance appraisal data interview should be supplemented by the data from the assessment center. Since the assessment center method is used to study the likely performance and behavior of a person in a role not previously performed by him or her, it can be used to supplement promotion decision using the additional input, not only results in a more appropriate decision. It also helps eliminate individual biases and imparts more transparency and fairness to the promotion system. Tools used in the assessment center. As mentioned above, the main characteristics of the assessment centers are the multiple methods of the assessment using multiple assessors. the main assessment tools that are used are the psychometric test. Psychometric test, in general, three types of the test or questionnaire can be used in the assessment center. Aptitude test, ability test, and the personality test. Three type of the test or questionnaire can be used in the assessment center. Aptitude test, ability test, and the personality test. Aptitude tests are those which attempt to evaluate verbal and the numerical reasoning ability. Ability test attempt to measure awareness, knowledge, and other such aspects. They also measure simple skills like problem solving ability, etc. For e.g., a chapter pencil test could be administered to find out the familiarity or the level of the skill of the individual in the relation to the computer literacy, financial management skills, etc. Personality tests are those tests which are aimed at studying various dimensions of the personality rather than ability. MBTI and 16PF are tests used in the many organizations. While ability and aptitude tests have right or the wrong answer, personality tests don't have the same. These are the psychometric tests are there. The tests are selected for the assessment taking the following points into consideration. Objective, what needs to be measured? Reliability and validity. Length of time required to administer the test. What are the length of the time required to administer the test? Ability of the qualified experts to administrator, scope and interpret the test. Ability of the qualified expert to administrator, scope and interpret the test. Cost involved. These tests are selected for the assessment taking the following points into the consideration. Objective, what needs to be measured? Reliability and validity. Length of time required to administer the test. Ability of the qualified expert to administer, scope and interpret the test. Cost involved. What are the costs involved in the test? Here, task is given there. Which appraisal method is more suited for appraising the following category of the employee? IT professionals, HR professionals, research professionals. Which method you can use for these professionals? Give suitable examples for choosing any particular method. Give suitable example for choosing any particular method. Common rating error in the performance appraisal method. Differences in perception and value system influence the evaluation. For instance, two raters observe an employee disagreeing with a supervisor. One perceives these an insubordination, but the other sees it as a willingness to stand up for what he believes in. Individual rather bias can seriously compromise the celebrity of an appraisal. Some of the common syndromes are the halo effect, horns effect, leniency or the constant error, central tendency, spillover effect, and the personal bias. These are the common syndromes. Halo effect. This is a tendency. Let the assessment of a single trait influence the evaluation of the individual on other traits too. Horns effect. This is a tendency to allow one negative trait of the employee to color the entire appraisal. This result in an overall lower rating than may be warranted. This is the Horn effect. This is a tendency to allow one negative trait of the employee to color the entire appraisal. This result in overall lower rating than may be warranted. Horn effect. Hollow effect. This is a tendency late assessment. A single trait influence the evaluation of the individual on the other traits too. Leniency or the constant error. Depending upon the appraisal's one value system, which acted as a standard, implies may be rated leniently or strictly. Such a rating does not carry any reference to the actual performance of the employee. Some appraisers constantly assign high value to the all employee, regardless of the merit. This is a leniency error. The strictness tendency is a reverse situation, where all individuals are rated too severely and performance is understand. Central tendency, this is the most common error that occurs when a rater assigns most middle range scores or value to all individuals under the appraisal. Extremely high or extremely low evaluation are avoided by the assigning the average rating to all. Spillover effect. This refers to following, allowing past performance to influence the evaluation of the present performance. Personal bias. Perhaps the most important error of all arises from the fact that very few people are capable of objective judgment entirely independent of their value and the prejudice. This is the personal bias. Personal bias is also one of the important type of the error. Spillover effect, central tendency, Horn's effect. The above errors have evoked concerns about the performance appraisal. MacGeorger, 1960, with his concern from the human side of the enterprise, appraisal represented a judgment and the demotivating process. Similar concerns were voiced by the Deming, 1982, who suggested that the appraisal was a deadly disease which blamed individuals for problems systematic to organization. Migration, 96, went as far as to predict that appraisal would fall apart at the seams due to the combination of the marginal indifference, employee ambivalence, and union opposition. This theme was reiterated by the Fletcher, who suggested that the days of the standardized appraisal were numbered. But despite these gloomy predictions, the use of the performance appraisal has flourished. This is the case study of the competency-based balanced scorecard model and integrative perspective. In the current globalization induced by the abrupt changes in the business environment, human resource have become the source of the successful corporate strategy. Human resource have become the source of the successful corporate strategy. This study emphasizes that the human resource and HR practices are the foundation for achieving the business excellence in terms of the ROI, market share, employee satisfaction, and the customer delight. The paper explains the implementation of the balanced scorecard by developing the competency in relation to the values of the organization necessary for achieving business excellence. And this paper explains the implementations of the balanced scorecard by developing competency in relation to the values of the organization necessary for the achieving business excellence. Introduction. In today's dynamic world, companies are adopting newer approaches for facing competition and achieving the business excellence. The new economic paradigm is characterized by the speed, innovation, quality, and the customer satisfaction. New economic paradigm. It is characterized by the speed. Number one, innovation. What innovation you do in the plant you are doing? Who is doing innovation? And quality. Quality of the service to the customers, and the customer satisfaction is there. How the customer is satisfied there. The sense of the competitive advantage has shifted from tangible asset to the intangible ones. Earlier, HR has concerned with the activity such as payroll, staffing, and employee welfare, but rules of the game have started to change completely as today organizations have to reckon with the global competition and match international requirement in terms of the product design. Product design is necessary. Designing of the new product and launching into the market is necessary for any of the organization. Design the new product. Process technology. Changing the process technology, establishing the quality standards and on-time delivery is the thing which is used for the global competition and to meet the internal requirement. It is said today that the business endeavors succeed or fail because of the people involved, and only by attracting the best people and making them perform the best will lead to the accomplished date. Based on the various study, it can be concluded that the firms with the more effective HR management system consistently outperform the competition. However, evidence that HR can contribute to a firm's success does not mean it is now effectively contributing to success in the business. It is a challenge for managers to make HR a strategic asset. This case justifies that there is a connection between the human resource and the business success in terms of the tangible and the intangible measures, and establishes a framework which could assist HR professional to make the human resource a strategic asset. Based on the balance scorecard and through competency framework, evident from the corporate practices, the author has established a competency-based balanced scorecard model. Company established a company-based balanced scorecard model. Balanced scorecard, developed in the early 90s by the Kaplan and Norton. The balanced scorecard is a management system that enables organizations to clarify their vision and strategy and translate them into an action, and has become a prominent strategic tool for the management. Summary, structure, and style have classified performance appraisal into the three groups: traditional performance rating, newer rating method, and the result-oriented appraisal. 360-degree feedback is also known as a multi-rater feedback, as it is the most comprehensive appraisal where the feedback about the employee's performance comes from all the sources that come in contact with the employee on his job. 360-degree feedback is also known as a multi-rater feedback, as it is the most comprehensive appraisal where the feedback about the employee's performance comes from all the sources that come in contact with the employee on his job. The quality of an appraiser is much more crucial than the appraisal method. It is desirable to make the immediate superior a party to the appraisal program. Performance is a thing of the past. While potential includes the possible knowledge, skills, and attitude the employee may possess for better performance. Keywords. 360 degree feedback or appraisal. It is the most comprehensive appraisal where the feedback about the employee's performance comes from all the sources that come in contact with the employee on his job. 360 degree feedback. The balance scorecard, it creates a template of measurement of the organizational performance as well as individual performance and enables organization to clarify vision and strategy before the initiating action. The balance scorecard, it creates a template of the measurement of the organizational performance as well as individual performance and enables organization to clarify vision and strategy before initiating action. Traditional rating. It involves a completion of a form by the immediate supervisor of the individual who is being evaluated. These are the keywords are there. And then self-assessment is given here. State whether the following statements are the true and the false. And the review questions are given here. What are the review questions which have been given here? Answers of the self-assessment is given there. And further reading is given there. References, further reading on the performance management is given there. In the next class, next lecture, Professor Dr. Manoj Kumar will discuss about the performance monitoring. Today we discussed about the further reading, review questions, self-assessment, keywords, summary, competency-based score card model and integrative perspective. Common rating errors. What are the common rating errors? This is important to know about the errors. Tools used in the assessment centers. What are the tools used in the assessment centers? Psychometric test, assessment center. It discussed about the assessment center. Promotions, how the promotions can be done.